There are some people who think that you put the double bridle on when you need the horse to give more at the pole, or that you use the double bridle to make the horse give at the pole. You can use a curb bit to make the horse give at the pole. However, the main job of the curb bit is to elevate the horse's neck through lightness and fineness. The snaffle bit is a very direct bit in that it lies in the upper corners of the horse's mouth when it's adjusted properly. The snaffle bit should not be used in a downward way on the bars of the horse's mouth. It should be carried lightly in the upper corners of his lips. The snaffle bit is the bit we use on young horses to teach them to go round, to go down with the neck and round up on the bit. As you add more engagement in a snaffle bit, you can also get the front end elevated. But if you're really at a stage where you need to elevate the horse's neck, it is the curb bit that will teach the horse that. There's no horse in his right mind who will lean on or clunk on a properly adjusted curb bit if you're using that bit singly. If I pick up only the snaffle and I put a little bit of upward contact on the snaffle and apply my leg, even in the halt, my horse should soften at the pole and round up on the bit. And in fact, he's giving you a really good example here. I take contact and he not only softens at the pole, he wants to lower his neck into the rein contact. Now, we don't always teach a horse this in halt. In the forward motion, we teach him that as we add energy from the hind leg into the hand and into the bit, he meets the bit and gives to it. That's the way a horse is properly told to give at the pole. Now, what should happen when I pick up this curb bit? What he should do is elevate the neck like this. He just lifted his neck up, and that might require some impulsion from behind, which is why I'm touching him with the whip. There we go. We want him to elevate his neck, and when he gives a little bit at the pole with the neck elevated, we give on the rein. So we can relieve pressure on, this is a leverage bit. You can see, if you're looking at his mouth right now, you have to stay turned so people can see, dude. You can see that when this bit moves in his mouth, it creates leverage. And when I give on it, it releases the leverage. So the curb bit, it has two effects on the horse. One is it puts pressure on the curb chain when you apply leverage. And the other is that it puts pressure on the pole when you apply leverage.